Good morning, guys. Thank you for allowing me to be with you. The earth is rocking and a rolling this morning. Yeah, and after I did my video last night about the weakening of the earth's magnetic field and how we're probably going to see more earthquakes. There was two earthquakes, one in Haiti, a magnitude 7.0, and another one along the Aleutian Islands, Perryville. USGS says it was a 6.9, but EMSC said it was a 7.0. Using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. Over here on the right is the Dominican Republic. This is an area where we have subduction coming from the north and from the south. I don't know if you can see my little arrows here. Between two fault zones. And this area is being crushed, pushed up, not far from Port-au-Prince. Yeah, there's some historical earthquakes that have happened in that area. And, huge tsunamis in the past. They're saying with this earthquake, there was no tsunami threat. USGS is saying it was 10 kilometers in depth. Often they put 10 kilometers when they're not sure. Here's the felt reports, and you can see we got Port-au-Prince. Port-au-Prince was the area where they had the 7.0 earthquake in 2010 that caused so much devastation right there, and Hillary Clinton ended up keeping the majority of the money that was sent to help the people. Here we have a list of earthquakes for Haiti. 2018, a magnitude 5.9, 2010, a 7.0, 1842, a magnitude 8.1. That one had a very destructive tsunami. In 1770, there was a magnitude 7.5. Also, that one created a tsunami. Port-au-Prince, 1751, a 8.0. Those two don't have anything. And then 1562, a 7.7. Yeah, when they had that great earthquake, they had liquefaction. People actually sank in the beach up to their necks. Many people were killed. I'm not sure which one it was, but there was a 30-foot tsunami. Maybe it was this one right here by Port-au-Prince. That tsunami went inland, destroying much of the area, by about 4.5 miles. Yeah. In 1751, there was an 8.0 right here in this location. Yeah, it's capable of having an 8 or larger. And as I've said in past videos about earthquakes in the Caribbean, if you have an earthquake that is large, do your evacuation straight up if there's anything standing that you can get to, because of the threat of tsunamis. Most of these areas have built along the coastlines because of the rugged terrain. And these are islands that were created by a volcanism. Yeah, it's real interesting. I've gone over that. And this whole area in the center, the magnetic anomalies are because it's being crushed coming from the north, the Atlantic Ocean. And then down south here, we got South America. We also got the Cocoa Plate. The Nazca Plate, yeah. The other earthquake, they do have a moment tensor ball. This was another subduction earthquake, a thrust earthquake, very deep, 33 kilometers in depth. EMSC said it was a 7.0, but USGS said it was a 6.9. Here we have the felt report so far. And then going back to Google Earth, we'll go to its location. It's very close to where they had that magnitude 8.0. Looks like they changed the location of this earthquake. originally, it was right here. Here's that 8.2. So they've revised it. Here we have the first wave of the earthquake, the P wave, which puts tension. Oh, looks like mostly north. And yes, from subduction. Looks like USGS has revised that earthquake now for Haiti to a magnitude 7.2. There is 568 earthquakes on this map right here in the last 30 days. And looks like we got an aftershock of about 3.6 and a 3.9. We'll go down through here for some of these earthquakes. Yeah, it's been a rocking over there. Yeah, like my report I did on the Sandwich Islands. Yeah, there's been a lot of earthquakes going on where we have subduction of the different plates. And that happened before when the Earth's magnetic field decided it was going to flip, and probably before it flipped or reversed, whichever you want to call it. But the continents actually moved during that time. And it probably lasted for about 20,000 years. Some scientists said that it lasted for about 10,000 years. The magnetic field back then didn't flip just pop all of a sudden, you know, to go where it is now, north and south. What it did was the magnetic field decided, like divots on a golf ball, went around the world, settling in different spots, you know, top, bottom, right, left, north, south, east, west. All picture a golf ball and all those little dots, those divots on a golf ball. The magnetic field bounced around on the Earth to all those different areas for 20,000 years until it settled where it is now. And during that time, there was great earthquakes, volcanic eruptions. Gives you an indication of what we got coming if it happens within our lifetime. USGS is now reporting an aftershock of a 5.2 there in Haiti. And the South Sandwich Islands now has 112 earthquakes listed for that area. That's another area of subduction. There by the Philippines, I covered that one too. That's another area of subduction. This is the Philippine Trench. There's been 15 earthquakes in that area after the initial 7.1. See, and these are all, well, basically all of them 5.0 or greater. There is a 4.8. Yeah, I think we got something major coming. 5.0, 5.3, 5.5, 5.3. And there's a 4.9, but you know they like to downgrade the earthquakes. And then there's that 7.1. Here's these earthquakes that are coming in. They're making the earth ring like a bell. Here we got Yellowstone Super Volcano. This is Madison River at the top. Yellowstone Lake, yeah, in the middle. That's a bigger signature, and it's not surprising because they got that crack at the bottom. Let me go back another 4 hours. So this one right here, I'm going to guess, I haven't really taken a look at the time, is probably the earthquake in Alaska. And then this one right here would be the earthquake in Haiti. And it's still making it ring like a bell. And there's only one small earthquake before these two that happened there at Yellowstone. You can see it right there. I'll do a report on that later. Yeah, the Haiti earthquake just really shook up Yellowstone's caldera. So that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments where the next great earthquake is going to be? Please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.